The moment you get into the map, tell everyone that the button is going to the right. I will explain this later. So, the first phase is DPS phase. On this phase, try to destroy as much body parts as you can. Every time you see a yellow part, grapple it and try to destroy it so your party can have more time to DPS the boss. Dealing enough damage will fill the second bar below the HP bar of the boss. Once the bar is full, second phase begins. On the second phase, the boss burrows on the ground and becomes immune to all damage, and then pillars spawn around the map. Now, at the beginning of this stage, we told all our party members button to the right because it is the way we position the buttons to redirect the electricity on the pillars. On each pillar, there are buttons and you can shoot it to redirect the flow of electricity. The reason why we go right so that it doesn't go against the current. If someone pushes left, the electricity will not be connected. You also have to shoot the buttons a couple of times until it points to the right. You have to be fast on this phase because all the pillars must be on the same direction to the right. As you are doing this, you need to protect the pillars from incoming fireballs. Every time a pillar gets hit by a fireball, it consumes one battery. The moment all the battery becomes red, the pillar will lose power and deactivate, and you lose connection. Once all the pillars are connected, the boss immune phase will end and it's going to be DPS phase again, and that is the fight. Last but not the least, equip defensive modules so that you won't get knocked down easily. If you have no idea what kinds of modules to use, you can copy my build. There is nothing special on this build, it is just a plain and simple tank build that can be used on any descendants. The most important part of this fight is not to get knocked down, as it wastes a lot of time reviving a downed party member. Now, I know that there are builds out there that deal so much damage, but the moment they get hit, they just fall on the ground, which is annoying and a complete waste of time, especially when a player is doing important mechanics. Now, I'm not forcing anyone to use this build, you do what you do, but just be careful and most importantly, have fun. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.